मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ कमिंग टू रिमेनिंग स्टेप्स इन रिकॉम्बिनेंट डीएनए टेक्नोलॉजी। ऑलरेडी सम स्टेप्स आर एक्सप्लेन्ड इन प्रीवियस क्लास। वन इज आइसोलेशन ऑफ डीएनए, टू कटिंग ऑफ डीएनए, थ्री आइसोलेशन ऑफ डिजायर्ड डीएनए, फोर इंसर्शन ऑफ डिजायर्ड डीएनए इनटू ए रिकॉम्बिनेंट वेक्टर। नाउ कमिंग टू रिमेनिंग स्टेप्स, amplification by PCR method, amplification, okay, amplification of gene of interest, amplification of gene of interest. Students, you know this is a gene of interest, and this is a plasmid vector. For example, there are 100 plasmid vectors, but only one desired gene copy is there. To ligate this desired copies, in order to convert this 100 plasmids into recombinant plasmids, there is the need of the multiplication of desired copy equal to the number of plasmid copies. Such a multiplication of desired gene copy can be done by PCR method. PCR means polymerase chain reaction, polymerase chain reaction method. Simply this is abbreviated as PCR. Okay, by using this polymerase chain reaction method, artificially we can multiply the gene of interest equal to the number of plasmids. Now this polymerase chain reaction, it involves two primers. These two primers are artificially synthesized. Chemically it is synthesized by, chemically these primers are synthesized by oligopolysaccharides. And these two primers are complementary with the gene of interest. So these type of primers are synthesized chemically by using oligonucleotides, and which are complementary with the gene of interest. In addition to these two primers, and here DNA polymerase enzyme is also required. DNA polymerase enzyme also required. Similarly, this is also required. Some substrates, they are deoxyribonucleoside triphosphates. Okay, they are used as these deoxyribonucleoside triphosphates, they are used as substrates. Okay, so these polymerase chain reaction, it involves RNA polymerase enzyme, two primers which are complementary with gene of interest, and substrates deoxyribonucleoside triphosphates. In this method, for example, this is a gene of interest. Okay, now this is the location to be amplified. Okay, now this gene of interest, it is heated up to 60 degrees centigrade or more than 60 degrees centigrade, resulting these two DNA strands, they get separated to each other because of heat. Now this is called denaturation. This is a denaturation, resulting separation of the two heads. Now the separated two DNA strands, they act as templates in the formation of new DNA strands, new DNA molecules. Okay, now these two primers, they are attached with these templates at a 3' position, and direction of this primer, this is 5' to 3'. Now this is another primer, 5' to 3'. This is called annealing. This is attachment of this primers to template strands is considered as annealing. Okay, now these primers, they extend, these primers, they extend the strands in a 5' to 3'. Like this is also extends. By using this deoxyribonucleoside triphosphates and in the presence of DNA polymerase enzyme, these primers, they extend the templates, leading to the formation of two DNA molecules. Now two desired DNA copies are formed. Now these two desired DNAs, they are also heated. Again, it's a chain reaction. Now these two DNA molecules are separated into four strands of DNA. Now four strands, they are also extended, resulting in the formation of total 8 DNA molecules. In this way, here, this is an extension. Okay? So the correct sequence of the various events in denaturation, annealing and extension. When this process is repeated up to 30 cycles, we can multiply the desired copies into 1 billion copies. Thus, we can use this PCR method to multiply the gene of interest artificially. At the same time, students, now coming to another point, very important. So this polymerase chain reaction, it involves the utilization of highly thermostable DNA polymerase enzyme, that is TAC polymerase. That is called TAC polymerase. TAC means Thermus aquaticus. This is one of the bacteria, thermophilic bacteria, which are generally present in high temperature, more than 90 degrees centigrade. So this bacteria can survive in high temperature, that is more than 90 degrees centigrade, so that the enzyme present, DNA polymerase enzyme present in this bacteria, able to maintain the replication even at a high temperature. So, to protect the enzymes from this overheating, we can use the TAC polymerase enzyme. That is polymerase chain reaction. This method is also used in DNA fingerprinting process also. Okay. Now, coming to another step. Introduction of recombinant DNA into a host. Okay. This is another step. Students, in order to insert this recombinant DNA into a suitable host, that is into bacteria or plant or animal, whatever it may be. First, the host, in case of bacterial cells, in order to insert this recombinant DNA into the host, first the host must be competent to the recombinant DNA. Host must be competent to take up the recombinant DNA. Already explained this point. When the bacterial cells are treated with a divalent cation like calcium, it renders and porous. It renders the cell wall and membrane and leads to the formation of some pores. Now these bacterial cells are forced to take up this recombinant DNAs from the surroundings. Okay, in case of bacterial cells, bacteria transformation is used to insert the recombinant DNA into the host. Transformation. What is translation? How we can introduce this recombinant DNA into the bacterial host? Now, these recombinant DNAs and bacteria. Okay, generally this bacteria, this is E. coli. They are incubated on ice. Now, these bacterial cells, they are transferred to heat shock. Okay, heat shock at 42 degrees centigrade. Now they are also transferred back onto the ice. This heat shock enables the bacterial cells to take up the recombinant DNA into the bacterial cells. Now these bacterial cells are forced to take up the recombinant DNA present in their surroundings. This is for bacterial cells. This is called transformation. But in case of animal cells, another method it is used for introduction of this recombinant DNA in case of animal cells. In this, recombinant DNA is directly injected into the nucleus of a host cell. This is called micro injection. This method is called micro injection. So in micro injection method, it is used for only animal cells. Here these type of recombinant DNAs, they are directly injected into the nucleus of animal cell. Such method is called micro injection. For example, in case of plants, which method is used for insertion of this recombinant DNA? In case of plants, biallelistic method is used. Biallelistic. This is also called gene gun method. Biallelistic method is also called gene gun method. So in this gene gun method, high velocity particles of tungsten recombinant, here it involves the plant cells are bombarded with high velocity particles of gold and tungsten. Gold and tungsten, which are coated with recombinant DNA technology. For example, this is gold or tungsten, and this is coated with recombinant DNA. So now this use high velocity particles of gold and tungsten. Cells are bombarded with high velocity particles of gold and tungsten coated with recombinant DNA. This is used for plant cells. Students, in addition with these type of methods, in addition with this, some disarmed pathogens, some disarmed pathogens, they are also used for transfer of recombinant DNA into the host. Disarmed pathogens. So these disarmed pathogens like retroviruses and TI plasmids of Agrobacterium tube patients. One is retroviruses and TI plasmids of Agrobacterium tube patients. So one is used for bacterial cells transformation, other one is used for animal cells micro injection, and other one is used for plant cells biallelistic or gene gun method, and other method used for insertion of this recombinant DNA into the suitable host, utilization of disarmed pathogens, retroviruses and TI plasmids. Actually, retroviruses, they cause cancers in animal cells, and TI plasmids, they cause crown galls in apple and other plants. Now this is causing genes are eliminated by using the method of recombinant DNA technology. Now they are converted into disarmed pathogens. Now these disarmed pathogens, they are also used in this insertion of recombinant DNA into the host.